So hello everyone, today we are going to see about the command line argument in C programming. In the previous videos, we have already learned about the file concept. We have gone through the text file, binary file. We have already seen about the different types of operations will be performed on the files. We have already seen about the low level disk IO functions also. We have already seen about how to read and how to write the data into the file, how to read the data from the files. Now, today we will see a very important topic of file handling, that is command line argument in C programming. You already know, till time we have executed lot many program using the IDE editor. With the help of editor, we have written the program in editor, we have compiled the program, and we have executed the program. Finally, we have seen the output. This is a normal practice whenever we are in the positions at a learning, or we are at a learning stage, or we are learning any programming. So every time we will use the editor, or we can say we will use the IDE. Once you are very confident, the next stage, if you are suppose a very good programmer, so you need to make a practice, you have to execute your program to the command line argument. So basically what it means, a command line argument. So command line argument is a parameter supplied to the program when it is invoked. Till time, whatever program we have executed, just you have write main or integer main or void main, after that your logic of the program. But suppose if you want to execute a particular program through command line, that means command line is nothing but your DOS shell. You already seen all of this thing in the computer workshops. DOS, that is disk operating system. Basically, if you're talking about the operating system, so operating system will be having two types. One is of GUI and another is of CUI. So basically, what is the difference between CUI and GUI? So CUI stands for command, or we can say character user interface, and GUI stands for graphical user interface. If you're talking about the GUI, in a normal practices, whenever we purchase any applications, whenever we will get any software, so you will get a GUI of that software. And GUI will be used by the end user. For example, if you are having a mobile application, suppose if you are using a WhatsApp, so you will be having a GUI of that particular application. You have to use that. You don't have to bother about the coding, how we are going to send the message, how we are going to receive the message, what is the coding behind that. We don't have to bother about that, because we are the end user, we are using that application, we are using that software. So whoever may use the software, these are nothing but they are the end user. So whatever software you are using, that means you are comes under the end user. That means you are the client, you are the customer, you are the end user, you are the terminal user. Okay, because you are using that things. But if you are a developer, so developer always used a CUI, that is a command user interface, a character user interface. So once you call it as an, you are a programmer, so always you need to use a command line argument. So if you are a beginner, or if you are a learner, agar aap learning kar rahe ho, aap seekh rahe ho, so you have to always use the editor, because you are learning something, you are learning the programming concepts. But if once you get master, then after that you have to use a command line argument. You have to execute your programs through the command line arguments. So it means that your GUI always used by the end user, whereas CUI, that is command user interface, will be used by a developer or will be used by a programmer. So there are two types of OS. One is a CUI and one is a GUI, graphical user interface, and a command user interface. So basically command line argument are used to pass some sort of arguments with the main functions. अभी तक हम लोगों ने जो भी प्रोग्राम्स एग्जीक्यूट किए हैं, वी हैवंट सीन, वी हैवंट पास्ड एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ आर्गुमेंट इन द मेन प्रोसेस. सो एनी प्रोग्राम यू वांट टू एग्जीक्यूट, वी कैन एग्जीक्यूट एनी प्रोग्राम विद द हेल्प ऑफ कमांड लाइन आर्गुमेंट्स. सो इफ यू वांट टू पास सम सॉर्ट ऑफ आर्गुमेंट विद द मेन फंक्शन, इफ यू वांट टू पास सम सॉर्ट ऑफ आर्गुमेंट विद द मेन फंक्शंस, एट दैट टाइम वी विल यूज अ कमांड लाइन आर्गुमेंट. So basically, command line argument is a parameter supplied to a program when it is invoked. Command line argument is an important concept in C programming. It is mostly used when you need to control your program from outside. It means that if you want to compile or if you want to execute your program through the DOS prompt, through the command prompt, if you want to execute your program through console, we will use a command line argument. So command line argument are passed to the main method or we can say main functions. So suppose one syntax is given here. Integer main, integer is the return type. Main is the main functions from where the execution of the program is start. After that, there is a brackets and under the brackets, we have passed two arguments. One is of integer type and another is of pointer of character type. So first argument is a integer argc. So argc stands for argument counter. Argc stands for argument counter. And character star argv, it means that it is the array of character pointer. It is the array of character pointer. So argv stands for argument vector. The argc stands for argument counter, whereas argv, so argv stands for argument vector of pointer type character. That means it is an array of it is a character array called as argument vector. It means that suppose if you say argument counter 3, if you say argument counter 3, it means that argument vector 0, argument vector 1, argument vector 2. So suppose if your argc value is 3, that means argument counter is 3, it means that we are having 3 arguments. So 3 arguments address will be held by the argument vector. It means that we are having the argument counter and argument vector. For this, in this example, suppose, so argc is the argument counter and argv is the argument vector. So suppose argument counter is value is, suppose if your argument counter is 3, it means that your argument vector will be having the size 3, at least argument vector 0, argument vector 1, argument vector 2. So always argument parameter, or we can say argument vector 0, always contains the name of your program. आर्ग्यूमेंट वेक्टर का जो जीरो पोजिशन पे जो भी आपका एड्रेस रहेगा, दैट इज नथिंग बट द एड्रेस ऑफ योर प्रोग्राम. दैट ऑलवेज योर फर्स्ट पैरामीटर, ऑलवेज योर फर्स्ट आर्ग्यूमेंट शुड बी अ नेम ऑफ योर प्रोग्राम. जिस नाम से आपने प्रोग्राम सेव किया है, दैट नेम इज योर फर्स्ट आर्ग्यूमेंट. After that, जो भी आप उसके बाद argument pass करोगे, that should be argument 1, argument 2, argument 3, argument 4. And that argument of any type, it can be of integer type, it can be of character type, it can be of any file name also. Okay? So that means the argc and argv. So argc is the argument counter and argv is the argument vector of a pointer type of character array. Okay? Now we'll see the simple example. So here I have included two files, sbr.h, fonio.h. After the integer main, I have passed two parameters, integer argc and character star argv. That is a common statement for command line argument. If you want to execute a particular program through command line, through command prompt, so you have to pass it two parameter. One is of integer argc and another is of character star argv. Okay. Now we'll see, I have declared one variable integer I. So if argc is greater than 2, if argc is greater than or equal to 2, after that I want to print what type of argument I have to pass. The aim of this program is whatever argument you are going to pass on the command line, you need to display whatever argument you have passed. You have to print the argument you have passed on the command line on the monitor screen. Okay, it means that suppose your argc equal to 2, That means always keep in your mind your ARGC, your counter value, argument counter value, always it should be more than equal to 2. It means that you already know the first argument always be the name of your program, and after that jo bhi argument hum log pass karenge, so that will be considered as a list of argument. So here just I have to check if ARGC is greater than or equal to 2. If it is s agar hoga, so print up the argument supply. We have to print how many arguments are supplied. So if argument supplied, we have print the message argument supplied. Uske baad kitne argument supplied kiye hain, it will shows the count. After that, for I is equals to 1, when I, the value of I is 1, okay, and I is less than ARGC, I plus plus. Initially, we have declared I as a 1. The value of I is 1. The loop will go till I is less than ARGC. ARGC is nothing but an argument counter. If you pass argument counter 5, if you pass the 5 argument, it means that your argument counter is 5. So that loop will be executed 5 times. If you have passed 3 arguments, it means that that loop is executed 3 times. If you pass 10 arguments, that means that loop is executed 10 times. After that, print of ARGV of I. It means that it will print whatever argument you have passed through on the command line, it will print the argument list. How many arguments you have passed. So when I is equal to 1, so ARGV of I, में जो भी फर्स्ट आर्गुमेंट का एड्रेस आया होगा, इट विल प्रिंट दैट स्ट्रिंग वैल्यू. जो भी आपने वैल्यूज पास किया उसका स्ट्रिंग आप यहाँ पे डिस्प्ले हो जाएगा. सपोज इफ यू पास 5, सो इट विल कंसीडर एज अ स्ट्रिंग बिकॉज देयर इज एन परसेंट एस. वी आर नॉट प्रिंटिंग दैट इंटीजर वैल्यू, वी आर प्रिंटिंग एज एन स्ट्रिंग वैल्यू बिकॉज एआरजीवी ऑफ इज अ कैरेक्टर टाइप. एआरजीवी आपका कैरेक्टर टाइप का एड्रेस है, इसलिए यहाँ पे प्रिंट करते समय हमने परसेंट एस लिखा हुआ है. एंड परसेंट सॉरी स्लैश टी मतलब आपका फर्स्ट आर्गुमेंट प्रिंट होने के बाद उसमें स्लैश टी एक टैब आएगा, उसके बाद फिर से सेकंड आर्गुमेंट, फिर टैब आएगा, फिर थर्ड आर्गुमेंट, लाइकवाइज. सो इस तरीके से आपने जितने भी आर्गुमेंट पास किए हैं वो आर्गुमेंट आपके मॉनिटर स्क्रीन पे इस लूप के थ्रू क्या हो जाएंगे, डिस्प्ले हो जाएंगे. नाउ एल्स इफ योर एआरजीसी इज नॉट ग्रेटर देन 2, अगर आपका आर्गुमेंट काउंटर ग्रेटर देन 2 नहीं होता है, सो इट विल प्रिंट आर्गुमेंट लिस्ट इज एम्प्टी. आपका आर्गुमेंट लिस्ट एम्प्टी है ऐसे डिस्प्ले करेगा, एंड फाइनली इट विल रिटर्न द 0. Now we will see how we will execute this program through the command line. So I will stop. So now see, this is actually the program. This is actually the program, simple program of command line argument. The same program I have typed over here. So this is a program I have typed in editor. Okay. Then I have to compile this program. Alt+F9. Okay. After that, I have to close this program. I have to execute this program through the command line argument. Okay, so just you have to go in file menu. After that, there is a DOS shell, DOS DOS shell. You have to click on this. After that, after clicking, there is C:\turbo3 source. That means your file is stored in C drive. Under that C drive, we are having Turbo3. Okay, and under that Turbo3, we are having source folder. So that source folder itself having the code of compiler. It means that suppose I'm started with a command prompt. So command prompt jaise hum log open karte hain, so always your command prompt on the C drive. So C drive, Turbo3 and source, because my all the programs are stored in the source file. I have stored all the program in source file. Suppose I have to execute the program with help of command prompt. ठीक है, DOS shell के थ्रू अगर मुझे प्रोग्राम को एग्जीक्यूट करना है, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड देर इज एन नीड टू पास द फाइल नेम. सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू एग्जीक्यूट द प्रोग्राम. The program name is suppose cmdpgm. I have stored one program with the name cmdpgm. I will press enter. So I haven't passed any argument. So there is argument list is empty. What written over here? You will get output argument list is empty because I haven't passed any argument. Just I have written the program name cmdpgm. Okay. Now again I will execute the same program cmdpgm. Now I will pass two parameters. Suppose file1, file2. I will press enter. So now you can see the argument supplied are file1, file2. That means I have passed two arguments. Actually, there are three arguments. One is program name, another is argument, and one more is argument. That is file1 and file2 are the arguments. And cmdpgm, it is the name of the program, but it is also considered as a argument 0. That means argument 0 is cmd program, argument 1 is file1, and argument 2 is file2. Okay. So likewise, suppose now विद द हेल्प ऑफ कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट यू कैन एग्जीक्यूट एनी सॉर्ट ऑफ प्रोग्राम, जो भी आपने सीके प्रोग्राम्स बनाए हुए यू कैन एग्जीक्यूट ऑल दिस प्रोग्राम विद द हेल्प ऑफ कमांड प्रॉम्प्ट. नाउ यू कैन सी सपोज आई एम हैविंग वन मोर प्रोग्राम इन सोर्स फाइल, सपोज द नेम ऑफ द प्रोग्राम इज ARM, सपोज वन ऑफ द प्रोग्राम नेम इज फिबोनाची, आई हैव स्टोर्ड द प्रोग्राम विद द नेम ऑफ फिबोनाची. ठीक है, इफ आई प्रेस एंटर it will ask for enter any number till you want to generate a Fibonacci series. Suppose if I want to generate a Fibonacci series till the 10th, you already know what do you mean by Fibonacci series. That means if the first element is 0 and the second one is 1, so next element is 0 plus 1, 1. Another element is 1 plus 2 is 3. So next element should be the addition of two previous digits. I want to generate the Fibonacci series till the 10th. 10 तक के मुझे Fibonacci series generate करनी है, so I will press enter, so it will generate. So 0, 1, 0 plus 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 2, 1 plus 2, 3, 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 plus 5, 13. So 13 display करेगा क्या? नहीं. I want to generate only till the 10th element. Okay. So likewise, you have to execute any sort of program with the help of command prompt. Just you have to type the program name and press enter. Your program will get executed itself through the command prompt. So that means the command line arguments. And it's a very important topic. Okay. Hope so. All are understood the concept of command line argument, how we are going to pass the argument with the main functions, or how we can pass the argument vector, what do you mean by argument counter, and what do you mean by argument vectors also, and how we are going to execute the program with the help of command prompts. Okay, so thank you, one and all, thank you.